Hello everybody, today I'm checking out a very affordable 240mm all-in-one liquid cooler by Cooler Master. This is the Master Liquid 240. Some of you might remember me testing the Pro version of it, and it did really well in fact, especially in terms of noise levels. However, this new Master Liquid 240 without the Pro in its model name should apparently be quite impressive too. Maybe just a bit more slimmed down when it comes to features to get to that very attractive pricing of only $85 currently. This cooler also supports the new AM4 CPU socket for AMD's new Ryzen processors. So thank you so much, Cooler Master, for sending me this liquid cooler for the review, as well as for the tests I'm going to do with Ryzen. And the packaging, the Master Liquid 240 itself, the two 120mm fans, then the backplate, all needed bracket screws, thermal paste, a Y-splitter fan cable, and so on. Last but not least, the warranty information and installation instructions. The Master Liquid 240 features a 240mm aluminum radiator with dimensions of 277 by 119.6 by 27mm. Two Master Fan Air Balance 120mm PWM fans, 652 2000 RPM fan speed, 66.7 CFMX airflow, 6 to 30 decibels noise level, 15 decibels max pump noise level, cold plate copper base, and socket compatibility. As always, all the recent ones such as Intel LGA1151, LGA2011V3, as well as AMD's AIM3 Plus, FM2 Plus, and even the new AIM4 socket as mentioned in the beginning. Now, just like the Master Liquid Pro I've tested, this non-pro version looks just as good and well made. The 240mm radiator makes a very good impression, and so do the pump and tubes. With the fans mounted onto the radiator, the unit looks complete. Quite nice, I should say, at least that's my opinion. Like on the Pro version, high quality flexible FEP tubing comes into play here, which according to Cooler Master should last you longer than rubber. A super nice touch in my opinion are the tube nylon sleeves. That really adds to the aesthetics, and I wonder why it's featured here on this unit, the cheaper one. Maybe Cooler Master just thought about it now and decided to go with it, ignoring the fact that the Pro version doesn't have sleeved tubing. Anyway, as for the pump, it's special. The special feature is its low-profile dual chamber. Fiber-reinforced polymer, FRP for short, construction is what this pump is made of, which resists lots of chemicals and remains unaffected by moisture or water. The fancy design with the blue LEDs we find on the Pro version had to go, however, to allow for a lower price. But no worries, Cooler Master has thought of you. The Cooler Master logo does still light up, in white to be exact. Readjustment and angle of the tubing on the pump is possible, so that's nice too. The pump plugs into the motherboard's CPU fan header, whereas the two fans connect to the included Y-splitter cable, which then connects to the optional CPU fan header on the motherboard. Cooler Master's Master Fan AB fans are fairly well built, and it's obvious the main focus is silence. There's even rubber padding on the fans to reduce vibration noise. When it comes to aesthetics, again a very nice AIO liquid cooling unit. By just looking at it, I wouldn't expect it to cost just $85, to be honest. It looks like Cooler Master didn't sacrifice too much quality there to be able to go for that nice pricing. But performance is what will tell us more about this unit. The backplate brackets and screws are all out of metal, so no issues with quality here either. However, the installation of the cooler, the pump, was a bit of a hassle. Something very unusual when it comes to liquid coolers. The fittings on the pump interfere with the fourth memory module closest to the pump. In my case, I therefore could only install three out of the four modules. The pump can luckily be rotated and be installed that way, however, it then interferes with the heatsinks on my motherboard, the MSI Z97X Power AC. Although I do have to say, most boards don't come with as many heatsinks as this one does. So in most cases, you shouldn't run into problems. But with some boards, such as mine here, watch out. Other than that, the installation went smoothly. But let's not waste any more time, let's bring on the temperatures. Okay. hey, the results didn't turn out the way I expected them to be. What many may have noticed is that the Master Liquid Pro 240 did in fact perform worse in my test. This now confirms what many viewers have assumed back then when I tested the Pro version. It looks like I received a sample that didn't perform so well, because today this cheaper non-Pro version is beating it by 1 to 3 degrees. But altogether, given the price of only $85, you do get pretty impressive results, although one should keep in mind that the Arctic Liquid Freezer 240 performs a little bit better than this Cooler Master unit at the same price. However, Cooler Master takes the lead when it comes to noise levels. The pump was absolutely silent, no sound coming from it, but also the fans weren't loud at all. But of course, there are quieter fans on the market. Still a very silent all-in-one liquid cooler. So is this the best one in terms of price-performance ratio? Maybe not, but very, very close. At $85, the build quality is excellent. That's very noteworthy here, and the only real drawback is the installation. I mean, you shouldn't run into problems with like 95% of motherboards, but it's something I wish Cooler Master would have taken a closer look at, since an issue like that could turn out to be very frustrating, no matter the price. Nonetheless, I can definitely recommend the Cooler Master Master Liquid 240. If it wasn't for the installation issue, I would have given it gold. Instead, it's my silver award. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you in the next one.